something unusual has been found lurking inside the walls of a Waikato house.
And it's a timely reminder that the noises coming from beyond the jib could be a sign of a bigger problem.
Buzzing around behind the jib of this Huntley home, an unexpected discovery was about to be made. Karla Ferguson thought she had a problem with rats, but when the wall opened up...
I shone my torch and there was just a mass of wasps all around my head. The amount that was there was... yeah, gave me a big fright.
Wasps. Thousands and thousands of wasps.
Holy smokes. Oh my gosh, it's just a fistful of wasps.
I was pulling out by the handful wasps, dead wasps from here, so yeah, easily 10,000.
And Carla's here now. Great to talk to you, Karla. What did you think when you first saw all those wasps?
Oh, it was just insane. More interested than anything else. Like, I'm not annoyed about my kitchen. It's just, yeah, it was fascinating to look at.
And a little bit scary?
A little bit, I suppose, yes. I still stood in the kitchen when he was starting to cut into the wall, not knowing if there was actually anything alive in there because I guess the curiosity just sort of took over.
And what tipped you off to the fact that you might have something living in your walls?
So it started off with wasps always coming into the house, flying around kitchen lights when it was dark out. And my partner Mitch could hear like scratching and gnawing in the wall, thought it was mice, went outside one day and that's when he sort of noticed them flying in and out of this little hole outside and sort of put two and two together and realised, no, that's actually what we thought were bees in the wall.
And did you think about taking to them with a can of Mortine?
No, I was more, I think, worried about annoying them, maybe getting stung myself if I tried to spray so many of them, so I sort of just managed to get them out of the house using light.
And Karla, you haven't been stung? You're okay?
Yeah, no one's been stung. The animals are fine, we're all fine. Like, it's crazy that, yeah, we spent all this time with them around us and no one got hurt.
And have they all gone now?
Yes, they're all gone. Thankfully.
But I understand that you did discover more than you expected.
So, yesterday we sort of noticed between two studs a little bit more nest running along the whole wall. So we got to it again with a knife and ripped some more off, and there is more nest sort of off to the side and up in the ceiling.
Wow. You know what? They obviously really just love it at your place.
Because I left them to it. I left them and they left me.
Yeah.
Well, I hope they've all gone for now. Lovely to talk to you, Karla. Mind those stings. We don't want you getting any of those. Take care. Bye.
Bye.
ASB and 7 Sharp, keeping you one step ahead.
Well, Karla is a lot braver than me, that's for sure. I wouldn't really like a whole lot of wasps buzzing around my kitchen.
Not when there are 10,000 of them living in your walls. That really is quite remarkable.
Have you ever been stung by a wasp? It's quite a different sort of a vibe than a bee.
Yeah, I've been stung by both. It's not nice.
No, because, of course, the wasp actually releases less venom than a bee because the bee goes all in with everything and then dies, sadly.
Well, it leaves behind its sac, doesn't
That's
it?
That's right.
You don't have to worry about that with a wasp. Yeah. Vinegar on a wasp sting.
Yeah. But the wasp will go dig, 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 dig lots of times.
Nasty critters.
Yeah, and they lurk in a particular way.